Girls of Reddit who have rejected people, what's the worst way someone has taken it? Welcome to WtfRedd, the only Askreddit channel that will blow your mind. Like and subscribe right now, to support Pepe's career as an independent musician. He shoved me into a wall, and busted my head open. I was taking a break at work behind the building listening to music, and enjoying the breeze, and coworker I constantly tried to avoid, because he was a creep started asking me out. I'd already been irritated, because of shitty customers and the overbearing heat inside, so instead of the usual brush off reply, I snapped at him, and made it clear I was in no way interested, had a boyfriend whom I loved, and that he needed to get the fuck out of my personal space. I went to walk away, and he grabbed my arm, to twist me around trying to back me against the wall, and when I managed to finally rip my arm away, and press him back, to get him off me, he got pissed shoved me. Back of my head hit the wall, split open about an inch and a half, bled a lot had to get about 7 stitches, he got fired, and also arrested for assault. He tried to say I had hit him first, but luckily there was a camera around back that caught the whole thing. In high school I turned a guy down, so he went around spreading rumors that he tried to fuck me, but my vagina was deformed and practically closed up. He spent the rest of the year talking shit about how nasty I was, unclean, unshaven, etc. Sometime about 5 years ago, he tried to add me on Facebook, and I blocked him. Fuck that guy. I spent months trying to convince people I knew how to wash my asshole. I turned down a guy that was known for being the popular guy, and I thought he was a bit of a dickhead. When he tried to kiss me, I turned my head the other way, said I wasn't interested and walked off. He grabbed my hand, spat in my face, and said I missed the best opportunity in my life and the only reason he tried to kiss me was because he pitied me. I'd gone out with a guy once that I'd met through a dating site, and we just didn't click. I told him exactly that, was very respectful of his feelings, and wished him the best. He was not receptive at all. He called me a whore, told me that he was going to find where I lived, and push me into oncoming traffic, really awful things. He wouldn't stop texting me horrible stuff about how I was a gigantic bitch, a total C*NT for leading him up, and that he hoped that someone raped me. I blocked his number, which thankfully stopped the messages, reported him onto the dating app, and thankfully never heard from him again. It was legit one of the scariest frigging things. Dude was an hint. Guy asked me out during an Uber pool ride. I told him I wasn't interested, and he started moving closer, and asking me why I wasn't interested and what was wrong with him. It was uncomfortable to say the least. My Uber driver, for some reason, thought it was hilarious to see me pressed against the door, to try and get away from this random guy invading my personal space. Thankfully no one has threatened my life. He sent me an email with a 3-page essay attached. It was written entirely in third person recounting his first rejection by a girl named Tania at the age of 16. There were a lot of solitary beach walks, she's the perfect girl talk, him not talking no for answer, and the story eventually ends with him drinking antifreeze, slipping into a coma, hospitalized and eventually recuperating. Only to tell poor Tania that she could avoid his and his parents' pain by agreeing to date him. The email said, "So you know what you are getting into. I was 19 and did not see this extreme level of crazy coming, but knew I needed to really make how I felt clear. I immediately called him to reiterate that I do not want to be with him. I no longer want to be friends with him, and if he contacted me again I would change my number. I'll let a friend of his know what was going on." 5 days later he called from a different number to tell me he was out in the country, one with a gun to his head, and if I didn't agree to be with him then and there he was pulling the trigger. I lied and convinced him I had to leave because I had a family emergency, aunt sick in the hospital, but we would talk the next day. Had mutual friend call him and report back as is suspected he was full of shit. Sure enough I was right, he was totally fine. He called the next day, and with the most sing-song creepy serial killer tone said, "You think you're so nice? What type of shitty human being doesn't agree to what someone needs when they tell you they are going to kill themselves? You piece of shit." I lost the plot. Told him I am changing my numbers, and the next time he contacts me, it will be the police involved. He just laughed the whole time, and told me he hopes I die alone, like I deserve. Radio silence for 6 years, until I'm getting married. I have an email from him. Hey. Wow, it's been a while. How are you? Would be so great to catch up sometime. Fucking psychotic asshole. Obviously I never replied and changed my email again. My sister got followed home by a dude she rejected. He went up to the house and started talking to her kids and telling them he was their new dad. Luckily, real dad came out in his police attire. Put a real quick into that. Edit. Want to clear up some confusion. My sister and the real dad are married, not divorced or anything. The guy followed her home from the hospital she works at, where he was a patient under her care. He made a move on her. She said no. There was no relationship between them besides nurse/patient. Well, maybe not in his eyes. I refer to my brother-in-law as my brother, mostly cause I'm too lazy to type it out, but also cause he's been in my life since I was a little kid. Brother was not threatening the man as a cop, but instead as a father. He just happened to be getting ready to leave for work at the same time. The guy ended up getting transferred to another hospital to be closer to his family after complications from overdosing. This is a slightly different take, but I turned a guy down for a date and he then posted a long snap story about how much he loves his wife that he had neglected to mention all that time. Cheaters will often do stuff like that when they feel guilty for trying to cheat. I had something like this before. Older guy I was working a film festival with, at the opening night he said something along the lines of, "You know there's something between us." When I ignored it, he started loudly repeating how he wished he'd brought his girlfriend, clearly trying to save face. Called me an ugly whore, and said no one would ever want to fuck me. He didn't like when I asked how I could both be unfuckable and a whore. I had actually heard of a lot of people doing this before, but I'd never had it happen to me, and when it did it was completely devastating. He told me I had to go out with him, or he would kill himself. He then said goodbye, very convincingly and emotionally, and turned his phone off/stopped picking up or answering any texts. I knew him from when we went to high school together, and so I actually had his best mates and his dad's phone numbers. I phoned them and sent the screenshots of the messages to them, absolutely hysterical and worrying that he was in a gutter somewhere. However, it was very quickly fucking discovered by his livid father that he was actually round a mate smoking weed, and he thought that this would at least get him a pity shag. What a complete and utter twat. When I broke up with my first boyfriend, I was with him for 2.5 years. He went crazy, threatened to kill himself, locked himself in the bathroom, etc. I had his mum calling me every night for a week saying he'd swallowed a load of sleeping pills or locked himself in the bathroom with razor blades, etc. She had the cheek to blame it all on me. Thankfully my mum set them both straight, and the only time I saw/heard from him again was about a year later when he came to the pub I went to every weekend with his new girlfriend to try and make me jealous. Then got jealous when I was talking to a friend who looks like a Viking. Quite pathetic really. We went on one date and I declined a second. A couple of days after that he called me and told me what I had been wearing that day. This went on for a couple of months. I'd literally never see him, but at least the 3 times a week he'd know exactly what I wore. When I was a nanny, I was walking around with the baby in the pram, and we visited a bookshop. A man in there started talking to me, and then asked me out. Very kindly, keeping my father's advice in mind about being kind when I have to reject men. When they ask me out, I said that was a nice offer, but my boyfriend might not be too keen on it. His response to that was to lean in and try and kiss me. I told him to get the fuck off me. He then exploded with rage and started screaming in my face. I was saved by the bookstore employee. The man stormed out of the shop. I spent the next few hours shaking like a leaf. What a champion. He was 15 at the time, and although the rejection happened over the phone, he was so irate that he illegally drove a car to the nearest place he knew to where my house was. I'd once told him I lived near the hospital and waited there demanding I give him more accurate directions to my house. In retrospect, I probably should have been more terrified than I was. He broke into my house and chased me into my bedroom, then spent 10 minutes shouting through my locked bedroom door that I should come out and have a reasonable conversation with him, adult to adult. This is almost exactly what an ex-boyfriend did to me in college. Please, I just want to talk to you. After smashing my bedroom window open in the middle of the night and trying to crawl through it. Fuck no. Thanks for tuning in for this WtfRedd episode. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the one and only Askreddit channel that will blow your mind every time.